Good morning students. The topics of today's discussion are phase shifters, attenuators, wave meters and rat race junction. We are going to start our discussion with phase shifter. Many applications require phase shifter to be introduced between two given position in a waveguide system. The phase shift required may be fixed or variable. Since phase shift constant beta is inversely proportional to the guide wavelength lambda g, the magnitude of lambda g could be changed to obtain variable amount of phase shift. Fixed amount of phase shift can be obtained by capacitive or inductive irises in waveguide or by inserting dielectric rod across diameter of a circular waveguide or by decreasing wider dimension of a rectangular waveguide direct dielectric slab is made of some low loss material such as polyfoam whose epsilon r is greater than 1. Now here we are having a dielectric vane variable phase shifter. This is variable phase shifter. Now here this is the locking screw. This is the vane or the dielectric slab and this is a simple slot within which this dielectric slab will move. This is the adjusting knob and this is the dial. Now vane specially shaped to minimize the reflection. This is the shape of this is so that there should be no reflections. Higher the dielectric constant of a medium, the more slowly a microwave signal in a waveguide travels. Most signal travel through center. Movement of slab with epsilon r greater than 1 towards center of waveguide means that signal moves more slowly the nearer the slab gets to the center. Now we can have the adjustment in the slab and to get maximum phase shift, slab is it at center. This slab will be in the center if we want to have maximum phase shift, but for minimum phase shift, slab is adjacent to the walls of the waveguide. We just move it out in this direction and this will be parallel to this plane and we can fix it by this knob. So for maximum attenuation, this slab is at the center and for minimum attenuation, the slab is adjacent to the wall of the waveguide. When phase shift is changed continuously from one value to another value, that type is known as analog phase shifter. If fixed rather than variable, phase shift is produced, that is digital or discrete phase shifter. Now digital phase shifter can be utilized in phase array antennas and analog phase shifter can be utilized in bridges, microwave bridges and instruments. Now next part of our discussion is microwave attenuators. Now attenuators are the devices which are going to attenuate some amount of wave and that will depend upon our application or as per our requirement. So to absorb completely without any reflection and also insensitive to frequency, this can be used for measuring power gain or loss in dB. For isolation between instruments, to prevent overloading, that is reducing power inputs and power input to particular stage. Now this can be again classified into fixed attenuators and variable attenuators. Fixed attenuators means they will absorb all energy, that is it will act as a terminator, waveguide terminator. These type of attenuators consist of short section of waveguide with tapered plug for absorbing material at the end. Tapering is there so that there will be gradual transition from waveguide medium to absorbing medium, and this tapering will definitely reduce the reflection at the interface. Another type is variable type. This is continuous or stepwise attenuation. We can vary the amount of attenuation. A rectangular may be flap or vane type, circular, rotatory. Now these are flap type attenuator. Now this is the flap. Now for the maximum attenuation we see this is at this position, at the center position. But for minimum attenuation, this flap is somewhere at the top. So there is no attenuation of the wave. These are again some fixed type of attenuation. This is the dimension A and B, and this is the material which is going to attenuate the wave. And this is the dielectric slab which is somehow tapered end, and signal is coming from this side, and that signal is going to be absorbed totally by this tapered plate, and this taper help in gradual transition from waveguide medium to the absorbing medium. So this will help in reducing the reflection in the waveguides. These are movable vane type attenuator. Now if we see this vane can be moved, and if it is in the center we will see it will provide the maximum attenuation, but if the position of vane is like this then it will provide the minimum attenuation. Now we are going to see the wave meters. Now this is the structure of a wave meter. Here A and B, these are the dimension of a waveguide, and here this is the circular cavity. This is circular cavity. This is shortening plunger. Now the shortening plunger, this is the shortening plunger which is going to decrease or increase this space. Shortening plunger is to change the resonant frequency of the cavity by changing the cavity length. This is the cavity length. By pressing it downward, it will decrease the length of the cavity, and by pressing it up, it will increase the length of the cavity. Wave meter axis is so placed that it is perpendicular to the broad wall of the waveguide. Now these are also of two type, transmission cavities and absorption cavities. Transmission cavities means they will pass to which they are tuned, means they are going to pass those frequencies for which they are tuned to. But in case of absorption type, they are going to attenuate to which they are tuned. So this is the formula for the resonating frequency f naught, which is given by c by 2 under the root of m by a square plus n by b square plus p by d square, where f naught is the resonating frequency. Now this cavity wave meter are rugged, simple, accurate, accuracy up to 99.9%. Now this mode is excited in the cavity through the coupling hole by magnetic field coupling. Any possible oscillation due to plunger can be avoided by the absorbing material we are using, and plunger position results in different cavity resonating frequencies. Tuning can be calibrated in term of frequency by use of non-frequency inputs and absorbing a dip in the power meters. These can be micrometer type or the direct reading frequency meter. This direct reading frequency meter we are using in our labs. So as we see, this is absorption type cavity wave meters. So this is the output, and when it becomes zero, then at that particular dip we are going to calculate, or we are going to see directly the resonating frequency, or we can see the frequency which are going to be generated by our generator. Now next is rat race junction. Now as we see the construction of this rat race junction, it is again a circular in shape having four ports, port number 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now we see port number 1 and port number 4, there is the dimension or electrical length or separation is 3 lambda by 4. This is electrical length, and the separation between port number 1 and port 2 is lambda g by 4. Port number 2 and 3 is again lambda g by 4, and port number 3 to 4 is again lambda g by 4. Now ports are separated by proper electrical length to sustain standing waves. Total race circumference is 1.5 lambda g, 3 lambda g by 4 this, and 3 lambda g by 4 this side. So in total it is 1.5 lambda. Now power from port number 1 splits equally in clockwise and anticlockwise direction into 2 and 4, and nothing enter port number 3. Now how this is happening? Suppose I say power is entering at port number 1. Now we see from here it is going to divide in clockwise direction, reaching port number 4, and in anticlockwise direction. Now we are going to see at which port these two wave, clockwise or anticlockwise, meeting in phase, and at which port they are meeting at out of phase. So we see when we are using port number 1 as an input port, then the signal which is coming in clockwise direction from port number 1 to port number 4, it is going to cover a distance of 3 lambda g by 4 to reach up to port number 4. And we see the respective, when the signal is reaching from this to this, it is covering lambda g by 4. When it is coming from this to this, it is covering total a distance of lambda g by 4 plus lambda g by 4, means lambda g by 2 from port number 1 to port number 3. And when the same reflection, same signal is reaching at port number 4, it is covering a distance of lambda g by 4 plus lambda g by 4 plus lambda g by 4, means total 1.5 1.5 lambda divided by 2. So because now what we have said earlier, when power from port 1 split equally in clockwise and anticlockwise direction into 2 and 4 and nothing enters port number 3. Now when we see power, one part of power is going to port number 4, it is covering total distance of 3 lambda by 4, and the part and the anticlockwise part, when it reaches to port number 4, it is again covering a total length of 3 lambda by 4. So the clockwise portion and the anticlockwise portion of the wave both meet at same phase, so there will be output at this point. Now when the same power is reaching to port number 3, the total electrical length covered by this will be 3 lambda by 4 plus lambda g by 4, means lambda g from 1 to 3 in clockwise direction. So this total length will be lambda g, and from anticlockwise side, when the wave is reaching to port number 3, it is covering a distance of lambda g by 4 plus lambda g by 4, means lambda g by 2. So the clockwise portion is covering a distance of lambda g, while anticlockwise portion is covering a distance of lambda by 2. So they are out of phase and they will cancel out. Similarly, the signal, the clockwise portion, when this signal is traveling in clockwise direction and reaching at port number 2, the total distance covered by this will be 3 lambda by 4, 4 lambda by 4, and 5 lambda by 4. So total will be 5 lambda by 4. And when it is coming from this port number 1 to port number 2, that is the anticlockwise component, that is again lambda g by 4. So this component and the clockwise component, which is covering a electrical length of lambda g, 5 lambda g by 4, and this component which is coming from 1 to 2 in anticlockwise direction, this is again covering a distance of electrical distance of lambda g by 4. So this component, anticlockwise component reaching at port number 2 and clockwise component reaching at port number 2, they are in same phase, so there will be some output at port number 2. So we can say when input is at port number 1, we will get output at port number 4 and output at port number 2, but no output corresponding to port number 3. Now suppose we assume input is at port number 3. Now it will divide equally between 2 and 4, but 0 at port number 1. So for combining two signal or dividing two signal, we are going to use this junction. If two unequal signals are applied at port number 1 and output proportional to their sum at port number 2 and 4, while differential output at port number 3. So this is the working of rat race junction, and its S matrix can be written as like this. You can easily say, now from here if I assume this is S11, this is S12, S13, S14. Now we see S11 and S13 will be 0, that we have already seen. If we are having input at port number 1, then we are having 0 output corresponding to 1 and 3, but we are having output corresponding to 2 and 4. This is illustrated by this first row. Now in second row we are seeing S equals to S of 21, this is non-zero value, and S of 23, means when our input is at port number 2, we will get output at port number 1 and port number 3, but not at port number 2 and 4. Similarly for the third and fourth. So this is S matrix is ideal condition. Ideally taken, we are neglecting the leakage coupling values, And under such ideal condition, the S matrix for the rat race junction will be this. So this is all about some of the microwave components that are phase shifters, attenuators, wave meters, and rat race junction. Thank you. Have a nice day.